everyone, and welcome. My name is Chris Bridges, and I wanted to come to you today and talk about a subject, and the title is simply, What Does Credit Have to Do With It? Before I get started, though, I want to thank you all so much for tuning in to me today, but most importantly, tuning in to SuperCon 14. So as you're listening not only to my talk today or anyone else's presentation, make sure that you are communicating and sharing with others on social media. Remember to use hashtag SuperCon 14. I ain't gonna worry about spelling it. You know how to spell it. Make sure you're using hashtag SuperCon 14. And then also, just to make sure that we can stay in touch, I want you to also use hashtag LOTCB, which stands for Living on Top with Chris Bridges. Make sure you're using that hashtag. And also, if you want to connect with me and follow with the conversations, you can also use hashtag Credit with Chris. Yeah, we have to get all the social media homework out of the way. So make sure that everyone knows how to connect. But thank you so much for being with me today. I already started saying my name is Chris Bridges. Let me tell you a little about who I am, and then I'm going to go into my message again. What does credit have to do with it? I am a mother, a wife, a sister, a friend, a number of things just like you are, but I'm also an expert, a media correspondent and consultant, a life changer. And today for this particular talk, I'm going to be your answer. So I want to make sure that you are staying focused and connected with me as we talk about what credit have to do with it. Now, thank you so much for those of you who are here. Maybe you're visiting with us online or you're here in the audience. I so much appreciate your time. Listen, I've got two goals, two outcomes for you today. One is to make sure that I educate, empower, and more importantly, ignite you to take action and really understanding about your credit. My second goal is to have an opportunity for us to connect beyond this conversation. So I want to make sure that by the time we finish with this talk, now that I've motivated you and encouraged and empowered you to take some action, I'm going to tell you exactly how you can do that. So let's kind of jump into the conversation. So I believe, challenged credit comes from really three main culprits or three causes. One might be behavior. What is your behavior that is potentially or that is directly impacting your credit? Maybe it's something you got into a debt with absolutely no intention on paying it back. You know, I heard a funny story recently with one of my partners at an automobile dealership, and she mentioned that people literally go in and buy a new car with no care in the world of how much that car is going to cost per month because they have all intentions on returning it. And I thought, well, how interesting is that? Number one, they're telling you, the person who's going to determine whether or not they're going to get the car, that they have no intentions on returning it. Well, needless to say, that type of behavior will absolutely impact your credit. So, you know, if you have a behavior like that, or maybe someone who just doesn't, you know, pay the bill, a number of those types of activities are going to impact your credit. How about decisions? Maybe not making the right decisions could have a major impact to your credit. And if you're listening or watching me right now, you might identify yourself in any of these two things, behavior or decisions. And that decision may be to pay one thing versus another. That decision may be, you know, not to respond to correspondence that's being sent to you. That decision may be to go shopping and not, you know, keep track of your money management. Whatever that decision may be, surely it's going to and potentially impact your credit. But then the third one, I told you that challenged credit can be impacted three ways or can be a result of three things. Your behavior, if you're taking notes, this might be a good time. Your behavior, your decisions, and then of course your lack of knowledge. This is the number one reason that most people are living a life today with challenged credit. It's not because they wanted to live that life. It's not because that's the life they desire. It's because they have lack of knowledge. If I looked around the room or asked you out there in the audience, how many of your parents actually taught you about credit? Very few hands would be raised right now. And I know mine would not. They'd be down here. And that's because my parents didn't teach me about credit either. And why is it that such a subject that is so critical and important in this country, we're not taught about it? It's almost like, you know, keeping something close-knit, and yet it could change and transform lives. So most of us who have gone through any type of challenge in our credit, it's behavior, decisions, or lack of knowledge. You see, my motto is, when you know better, you will do better. And so knowledge is transformational. It is key to really unlocking those doors and understanding about credit. Now, Here's what I say often, and you all will understand. Credit does not define who you are. It makes life a lot easier though, but it is not who we are. Having challenged credit, whether you're in a 350 of 650, by the way, that's all kind of in that negative, range, but it doesn't say that you're a bad person. What it has said is that bad things potentially have happened to you, or lack of knowledge has allowed you or had you make bad decisions, as we've talked about. Now, there are some of y'all who have just is jacked up because you've made jacked up or had jacked up behavior, but we know that that too shall pass and can be changed. So listen, it's very easy actually to restore your score. What's more complicated and challenging is to retrain your brain. So I'm here today to share real quick about the things that you need to do to be retraining your brain. Remember, improving your credit score, that's easy. Get beyond that. If that's what was holding you back, I just set you free, free of bondage of having challenged credit, because you can restore your score. But you've got to first understand and realize that you have to retrain your brain so that you know that you can have better when you do better. To me, credit is the foundation. That's what it is. It's the foundation to your financial freedom. It doesn't define who we are. And in some cases, it's not the end all to be all, but it is the foundation for you. What are you standing on? What is your foundation? And if you're not happy with it, what are you going to do about it? Credit worthiness is critical. And whether you are an individual listening to me or whether you're a business owner listening to me, your credit worthiness will open up and impact a lot of opportunities for you. So again, it doesn't define who you are, but your credit worthiness will say where you can go in your future. Where are you today? That's a question for you. It's not for me. A lot of people contact me and say, oh, this is my motivator. I want to do better. I need to have better credit because of whatever reason. Maybe I want to buy a house. And here's a tip for you. You can buy a house with bad credit today. So don't let that be your only defining motivator. But maybe it's you want to have better for your children, or maybe you want to leave a legacy. Whatever it is, maybe you want to start that business that you just can't start because of your credit worthiness. Maybe you want to expand that business, but you can't do that because of your credit worthiness. Whatever it is, maybe you just want to be able to apply for something without having the jitters or the concerns about being denied. Whatever it is that is driving you, you have to determine it today and ask yourself the question, where am I with my credit and am I happy about it? Listen, we can't change yesterday, but we can change our tomorrow today. That's, again, those decisions that you have to make. You can't change what happened in the past. So if you've had challenged credit because of your behavior, your decisions, or having lack of knowledge, you may not be able to change that, but you can change your tomorrow by taking action today. Listen, I want to tell you a few stories as we talk about, what credit does for you. I had someone come to me recently and they worked with me, and after working with me, they were able to go forward and apply for their mortgage. And they told me the story when they first went to apply for the mortgage, that they had everything else in place. You see, they had money in the bank. They already had gone through home buying classes, so they knew not to be one of the 99% who had lost their homes through lack of knowledge or education. They had already done all of that. The one thing that was stopping them from purchasing their home was their credit score. And once they worked with us and got an opportunity to improve their credit score, then they were able to get into a home. Can you imagine the feeling that those parents felt when they were able to bring their kids into their home and call it their own? You know, a lot of times we're paying rent, we're paying other people's mortgages, and we're just deferring our dreams because we're not taking action. And so that story touched my heart. I have stories, countless stories like that, where people who actually had doors closed on them, but took the necessary action to take the steps to improve their credit, and then the doors just opened. You know, another thing I want you to imagine, just close your eyes and just imagine walking into maybe a car dealer. As we know, cars and houses are the two major purchases. And there's someone watching me today or listening to me today that is in exactly that same situation. And they want to buy a house so bad, they want to get a piece of the American dream, or they want to buy their dream car. Well, Well, just imagine going into the car dealer and you're already walking into the car dealer pre-approved, which means you already know your buying power and your credit worthiness. Wouldn't it be awesome if you could just close your eyes and imagine walking through the dealership with your check already in your pocket and being able to go in and pick the exact car that you want with the exact interior? You can almost smell that new car smell. And you walk in and you say, this is what I want. I don't need to test drive it. And I want it at this payment. And I need it wrapped up in an hour so that I can leave. What a feeling. Well, when you have good credit, that's exactly the kind of command that you can take. That's exactly the kind of feeling and power that you have. But when you're challenged, your credit is challenged, you don't even know whether you're going to make it to the finance manager. There's nothing like someone saying, just a minute, ma'am, sit here for a minute, we'll be right back. Your palms are sweating, your heart is beating, because you don't know what the answer is going to be. And maybe you're in a situation where you need that vehicle to get to work on Monday to pay the rent for the next month. You all know exactly what I'm saying. I know you feel me, because you yourself has maybe had these types of experiences, or you know someone that has. And that's not what we want for you. We want you to be able to live on top. We want you to have better. And having a good credit opens up those doors, so you won't be one of those individuals. How about if you're a business owner and you want to grow your business? You might be at a place right now where you either need to close the door, or you're at a place where you want to expand your business to keep the doors open. You know, most businesses, they don't close down because they aren't brilliant or they don't have a passion for what they do. They close their doors, guys, because they don't have the capital to continue to fund it and keep it open. And so credit worthiness for your business and or your individual consumer, those are the keys to unlocking those doors. So whether you want to buy a house, whether you want to buy a car, whether you want to extend or expand your business, or whether or not you just want to have more options, credit gives you options. I played a video yesterday on my broadcast, Living on Top, and the video was funny. It was called Don't Buy Something You Can't Afford. And I thought, what a novel idea. Don't buy things that you can't afford. But again, remember I told you that it's easier for you to restore your score than it is for you to train your brain? So when you can't afford something, you have to think about, what is it that I need to do? Am I going to buy it anyway? Or am I going to maybe leverage the credit for something that I can get today and pay for tomorrow? But if your credit is not good, you don't even have those options. So listen, one of the things I want you to understand as well, if you're watching me and in the audience today and you are a business owner, you may be listening and saying, you know what, my personal credit is jacked up. How do I get from point A to point B to get to a place where I become credit worthy on my individual? Or you may be listening or watching me and you're saying, you're talking about credit worthiness. I want that for my business so that I can extend and grow my business. Well, a couple of reasons why I want you to start considering that. Separating and growing business credit is critical. So I'm going to take a quick minute, because this is a conversation about credit, period. At the end of the day, whether it's for you as a consumer or for you as or a business owner. But what good credit does for you as a business owner is it allows you to separate from your personal. So it allows you to increase your potential of growth while decreasing your risk and liability. I talked earlier about the story of a business owner who needs to expand. Maybe you need to invest in some materials. Maybe you need to invest in some inventory. Maybe you need to hire more staff. Maybe you need to cover payroll. Well, if you have challenged credit and you're not credit worthy for you as an individual or your business, you won't be able to do that. So it's very, very important that you understand out the gate the criticalness of establishing good credit for your personal as well as for your business. And it's not as hard as you think. So listen, you know, people that you're watching me and you're kind of saying, hey, she's talking about credit. All right, I can relate to some of those questions. Those stories, I understand the importance, but how do I do it? Chris, how do I get off of the hamster wheel that I call the financial wheel, where it just keeps rolling around and around? How do I do something different and have better for my life? Well, you know what? It's real simple. It's like what Nike says, just Do it, but do it now. Stop procrastinating. One thing I will tell you, it's easy to restore. I said it's easy to restore your score, but if you don't take action, it's going to look the same. So, you know, if you don't take action today, 6 months, 6 years from now, your credit may look the very same or very similar because you've not taken the necessary actions to make any improvements. So how? Just do it. Because when you combine the knowledge and the action, you get the results. Again, when you combine the knowledge and the action, you get the results. So if you're listening to me and watching me here today, thank you so much for your time. This was just a nugget. I came here to empower and compel and motivate you to look at your credit, find out where you are. If you're not happy where you are and you want to make a change in your life, then I encourage you to connect with me. One of the things that I mentioned is I am a credit expert, but I am purpose in walking in my purpose in doing that. I'm passionate about it. But listen, only contact me if you're serious. If you're not serious about investing the time and maybe the cost in yourself, don't even bother. You could find me out on any of the social media if you just want to click and say hello. Credit with Chris, you can click and say hi. But if you're serious about taking action and improving your credit and living a better life, then I want you to take specific action right now. And if you're watching, write it down. I want you to do one of two things, whatever is easier. Get your cell phone out. I want you to text the word credit, C-R-E-D-I-T, text the word credit to 301-880-0041. Text the word credit to 301-880-0041. You're going to have an opportunity to connect with me directly. I'm going to take my time out of my busy day to spend time and talk with you about how we together can work to get you to a better life. Again, if you just want to say hi, hit me up on Twitter, Facebook, or LinkedIn, Credit with Chris. But if you're serious about doing something this year about your credit and you're tired of living the way you are, you're tired of worrying about what everybody else thinks about you, and you're ready to divorce yourself from the opinions of others and take that necessary action in order to see some improvements in your life, then you text me. If you don't have a text or your phone's broke or whatever, you can also always go straight to the website, goodcreditwithchris.com. Again, that's goodcreditwithchris.com. Again, reach out to me. I want to be here to help you. But if you're not serious about making a change, understanding what it's going to take in order to get you where you are into living and open up some unbelievable doors so you can have a better life, starting to think about building wealth and leaving a legacy by using other people's money, if you're not ready to take that step, don't reach out. But if it's you, and I know it's somebody in this room or that's watching us online, if it's you, I want you to take that action. Again, just simply text the word credit to 301-880-0041. Again, 301-880-0041, or go to goodcreditwithchris.com and register to spend some time and talk with me for you as an individual and opening up doors and making your life better, or for you as a business. Let me help you define the necessary actions to become credit worthy. I thank you so much for your time. Again, if you want to connect with me and just say hi and follow some of the magnificent and amazing things that we're doing and people like us that are out here in this community of serving, connect with me, Credit with Chris. Also, tune in every Tuesday at 3 o'clock for Living on Top with Chris Bridges, which is our online broadcast. And you can go to livingontop.info as well and connect with me there. We also have an amazing radio broadcast with my co-host Barrett Matthews on Lunch and Learn with Chris and Barrett, and that is every Friday at noon. So we're doing some things, we're pouring out into the community, and we just invite you to connect and stay connected with me so that I can help serve you, and in turn, you can serve others. Until then, you all stay blessed, and it was a pleasure. Thank you so much for your time. Bye-bye.